The body of a human adult contains up to 50 trillion cells, each cell consisting of over 40 million molecules. Understanding these molecules is not only key to understanding life, but also to understanding, predicting, and even curing diseases.
But molecules are too small to observe directly. The study of molecules in detail, known as structural biology, is made possible by a variety of techniques. Using a technology called X-ray diffraction, we can reveal the atomic structures of molecules.
To do so, the molecules first need to be crystallized. The crystals are then placed inside a very strong beam of X-rays generated by so-called synchrotrons.
A synchrotron accelerates particles to a very high speed, using them to produce high-energy X-ray photons. X-rays can only show us how atoms are positioned in crystallized molecules. Due to recent developments in cryo-electron microscopy, we are now also able to study large, complex biological molecules.
After capturing them in a thin, frozen layer of a solution, we use a powerful electron microscope to take pictures of these molecules. Multiple pictures are then combined to compute three-dimensional structures, revealing the exact position of the atoms within them. The images produced by the X-ray and cryo-EM methods are primarily static. To fully comprehend how molecules work, we need to understand their interactions and dynamics as well.
To do so, we can make use of X-ray scattering, visible light, or a method called nuclear magnetic resonance. The latter can even be used to directly observe the motion of molecules in solution. The molecules are placed in a strong magnetic field and exposed to radio waves, causing the atoms within them to emit high-frequency signals. We can then measure these atomic signals and deduce the details of their motion.
Structural biology techniques can also be used on cellular material. This results in pictures that demonstrate how the different molecules within a cell are positioned, as well as revealing all the ways in which they interact.
These various techniques are of such importance that the European Union has offered funding to facilities that have the necessary instruments available,
enabling researchers throughout Europe to perform the most demanding experiments in the best way possible.